Before starting with the laws of exponents, let us first recall what are exponents. So one of the example is 2 raised to the power 3. So this particular form is known as exponential form, whereas 3 is known as the power and 2 is the base. And this whole particular way of writing is known as exponential form. So let us try to understand what does it mean. So 2 raised to the power 3, this is the way we pronounce this. So 2 times 2 times 2. So this means 2 raised to the power 3. So answer is 8. So this is the basic meaning of an exponential form. Now let us focus on the laws. So our first law is the same base law. So a power m times a power n equals to. So basically in both the cases the base is same and powers are different. And laws of exponents works only in case of multiplication and division, not in addition or subtraction. So let us take an example. 2 power 3 times 2 power 4. Suppose we know that 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2, and 2 power 4 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, so 4 times. In totality, so we got 3 here and 4 here. So in total, we have 2 raised to the power 7. So basically what is happening, we are adding the power. So the law becomes a power m plus n. Our second law is a power m divided by a power n. We can also write it as a power m upon a power n. So it means the same thing. So we are dividing, so same base. So let's take one example, 2 power 3 upon 2 power 2. It can be higher also, it can be 4 also, but that will be a negative. Let's take 4. It will give us one more law. So it becomes 2 into 2 into 2 upon 2 into 2 into 2 times 2. So 2 and 2 get cancelled. So we are left with 1 over 2. So basically 1 over 2 power 1. So at the end, if you want to take the answer in numerator, so let us try to understand what is happening. So it will come to be as 2 power minus 1. Okay, so basically we are subtracting 3 and 4. 3 minus 4 is 1. That's how we get it. So law becomes a power m minus n. This is the second law. And from here we can understand one more law. If you are in negative, the power is negative, so a power m minus m can be written as a upon power m. Negative power can be removed by doing the reciprocal of the base. So this property can also be understood as this, a upon b power minus m. So the answer becomes b upon a power positive m. So we have to make the positive power, so this answer is also correct. This is property number 3. Next comes when powers are same and bases are different. So in case of powers are same, just like in when the bases were same, we were taking base one time. So in this course also, we will be taking power one time. And here we will be just simply multiplying. And here we will be dividing. Let us take one example. Suppose 2 power 3 multiplied by 4 power 3. So we will be writing it as 2 into 4 power 3. So that is 8 power 3. If you want to solve, you can solve. Similarly here, suppose this is 4 power 3 divided by 2 power 3. We will be writing as 4 divided by 2 power 3. And this gets divided 2 power 3. So this is when the power is same. So our sixth property is very important. A raised to the power 0. A means anything raised to the power 0. When I say anything, it means simply anything. If it does not make any sense to you, even then, suppose e power 0, that is also 1. So sine theta is power 0, that is also 1. This way you will be studying in class 10th. But I am just giving you an example. Suppose 1 upon 2 power 0, that is also 1. So anything raised to the power 0 is 1. If you want to understand why, so we have made a separate video for that, so you can watch that. Now coming to the this thing, 1 raised to the power anything remains 1. Why is it so? 1 raised to the power 3, it is 1 times 1 times 1, it is still 1. When I say anything, it means anything. So 1 raised to the power, suppose 0.5, okay? So it will lead to some other concept also. Just be patient. 1 raised to the power 1 upon 2. So for this, I will be taking a next law. So our next law is A raised to the power 1 upon n. So that means if a number has a power as fraction, so what happens is it becomes a root n. So let me just give you an example. Suppose it is 25 raised to the power 1 upon 2. It means that square root of 25. We know the answer is 5. But how do we get to know from here? So 25 can be written as 5 times 5 power 1 by 2. So we got 5 power 2 1 upon 2. And power is the power. So this is our ninth law. A power m power n. So this will give us a power m times n. So when there is a power up raised to the power, it becomes multiplied. So we will be multiplying these two numbers. So 5 power 2 times 1 by 2, it gets cancelled, we get 5. See, both the answers are same. So instead of doing this whole process, we can do it directly. But you should have this understanding that we can go both ways. If it is in fraction, we can go to roots. If we are in roots, we can go to the power as fraction. One thing I would like to add over here, this one can be some other variable also. So suppose a power m upon n. So as we have discussed this thing, that these two can be multiplied, so can I write it as a power, suppose m power 1 upon n. That means they were getting multiplied. So basically it is getting multiplied. It will give m upon n. So can I give this m to a? So a power m 1 upon n. And we know this will become root. So it becomes root n a power m. So basically you can have the direct formula or law. This n, the denominator becomes the root power, and this numerator becomes the power of the base. This is again the extension of this law. So we have to solve this thing. As we got to know, this is in root, so I can write it as root of 1, and root of 1 is 1. So as we got to know, 1 power anything is always 1. Remember this thing. So 1 power anything means anything. Suppose sine theta, it becomes 1. Similarly, here I'll give you one question. If it is a power m power n, this is different from this. Discuss your with your friend. I'll give you one example. Suppose I'll take 4 power 2 power 3 and 4 power 2 whole power 3. Check yourself and tell in the comment section, or ask, discuss with your teachers how they are different. For now, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.